Welcome back, YouTube. This is going to be episode 6 of our Let's Play series. We left off just getting to the death-touched catacombs, so that's where we are going to push through today, and we are going to explore a little more of this area, and then probably these little ruins right here. I want to check those out, and then we're going to go back down here and attempt to fight the Forlorn Hound Goal again, and then this looks like another place I want to look at, so we're gonna go check that out. Anyways, let's get into it.
Maybe in the far future, like for like one time ever, like just like a one time thing, if I can't find something to do, but I don't know, I think it's just like an idea of like, even if people liked it, I don't want to mix the content and I don't want to make another channel. I
want it to be very good. So we probably gotta find a lever or something to open up this door. Like the boss room. Backstab. Good.
I mean, we can try to go for like a 900 hit limit.
Pretty sure these skeletons will just keep respawning if you don't kill them once they're dead when that little blue glowing light comes on. So it's always something to be aware of. Grave Glovewort, Human Bone Shard, and some arrows. Strength and Ashes to plus one. So I guess we can level up our spirit summons. That's pretty cool. Money. Scripture Wooden Shield.
Ruthless Mod Laron. Laron is
ruthless. I like to use shields to give me 100% block protection on physical. So we're going to pass on that one at the moment. Boards. looks like our lever. Blood rose. It's probably a crafting material. Another path. I don't think I did, but I guess I could be wrong. Down. I can poke you too, buddy. The Ucha Katana. Be worth switching out to. Causes blood loss buildup at 45. Still getting shot with arrows. It's weapon art is like a supercharged up unsheath ability. Let's see how this fares for us. I do like the moveset on it. Human bone shard. Go check out that big log door at the beginning and see if we get a boss fight.
Can you just save quit if you get bad RNG? There's no save quits. I don't think save quits on any challenge run for DS3. Unless it's like a thing where
it's what it's looking like. Black Knife Assassin. Seems like he moves super quick, but he just keeps cowering in the corner. Stop. That's the last of every bit of healing I can get. Got him. I just kind of face tank those last little hits to try to kill him. A little bit greedy, but it worked, and we got the Assassin's Crimson Dagger. It said I got the Assassin's Crimson Dagger. Oh, okay. It's a talisman. Critical hits restore health. Huh. That could be kind of useful. And a death root. Beast clergyman seeks and devours these. So we gotta turn them into someone. Is there anything else back here? Root resin. Alright, well, that seems like that is it for this dungeon. Not too bad. Got us a new weapon to try out and possibly upgrade. Let's go ahead and rest here and see where we want to push on to next. I kind of want to go take this guy on again, but first, let's see if I have enough materials to upgrade this Ucha Katana and see if it holds up against the halberd we've been using.
Yeah,
doesn't seem to have as much reach, but I mean, it is just a katana versus the halberd. I like the moveset on this quite a bit more. Plus one, plus two, plus three.
He's boorish, blunt, and couldn't find his nose with both hands. But he's a good egg. I think the two of you are sure to find the best in one another.
Sorry about that. My YouTube crashed. If you guys have been following along in the series, I did, after I uploaded, realize that episode 3 did not record my voice at all for some reason. So I do apologize about that. I don't know what happened. Anyways, let's go try to take this thing on again. And then hopefully we can wrap up the Limgrave exploration today and we can start pushing up towards the Stormvale area and exploring that in the next episode. Oops, wrong button. Alright. See if we can do this now. So I guess if you talk to this guy by snapping your fingers in the woods, you can now summon him here to help you in this fight. That's pretty cool.
Darrowell, rotting in a cell is no true justice. No. This is where it ends for you.
Oh, it's been a minute since I fought him. Hit pretty hard. So does this guy. Jeez. And that is it. So that dude made this simple. And we got his weapon, the Bloodhound's Fang. Hell yeah. Let's see how good that thing is. Requires 18 strength, 17 dex, DNC scaling, causes blood loss buildup of 55. Let's see if I can check the moveset out. Okay, swings like a normal curved greatsword. Ooh. Okay, that's pretty cool. This is the weapon art. Do a uppercut slash and then leap backwards. Pretty cool little get out of the way.
Right. There you are. Had to work for it, but it's done. Don't say I'm not a man of my word. Here's your prize.
Okay. Somber Smithing Stone 2.
Oh, yes. I should say, if you venture north to Rhea Lucaria and come across a venerable blacksmith who's a little on the large side, tell him I sent you, and he'll be sure to treat you right. I owe you one, I reckon. That's enough chit-chat for now. It's time we parted ways. That's enough chit-chat for now. It's time we parted ways.
Okay. Stats at 16 and I need 18 17. All right, so we explored that area, we did the Death Touch catacombs. Let's front. We may not get to this area today because this is past the Stormveil Gate, but let's go check out those ruins there. Actually, probably need to put some points, level up. Let's see what we can do. Looks like we can get one level, so let's get the strength. That way it looks like we are only two levels away total. Real quick, I want to take this off. And I can't have a different talisman. Can I say anything? Unthinkable, our hallowed resting place is violated. To refuse the Erdtree's call to return, to live within death, sickening. I think I've already seen that before. It's awfully stormy up here. Zucci. A single basic attack hits 107, 217. Wonder if we can make that drop or if there's a grace down there. I feel like we're gonna die. Let's go this way a little bit and see if we can make that drop off a little bit shorter. There we go.
Hello? Can you hear me? Help me. I'm stuck. Hello?
Hello?
My stars.
The Kool-Aid Man?
I am Alexander,
also known as the Iron Fist. And as you can see, I'm stuck here. Please, can you help me out of this? My thanks, a thousand thanks. Just give me a good smack from the rear with something nice and big. And I'll pop clean out, I'm sure. Don't dally. There's no need to fret. I'm very well trained.
Okay.
Give it your all, I say.
So I guess it's gonna make us hit him. Got a new emote, the Triumphant Delight. This guy is out, don't attack me. It's the Kool-Aid Man. Oh yeah.
Well played, good sir. That mighty wallop of yours almost spelt the end of me. Well, I'm out now, and that's what counts. I thank you. And as a token of my appreciation, I'd like you to have this.
Exalted Flesh.
Once again, pleasure is mine. I am the warrior Jar known as Alexander. Iron Fist Alexander, in fact. I journey to the east, where I intend to further my education in the ways of war. And beyond these lands lie the scarlet, rot-blighted Kaelid Wilds. And upon their southern edge is Redmane Castle, in which a festival of combat is being held. I'd heard whispers of such festivities before. Doesn't the notion set your breast aflutter? I'm heading eastward to Redmane Castle on the southern. I've heard there's to be a.
Okay. Apparently, somewhere to the east, there is another castle and there's a festival being held there. Definitely have to check that out later. Yeah, a little roly-poly. Get back here. Teardrop Scarabs. They are both Crimson and Cerulean Teardrop Scarabs. Defeat them to replenish the flasks that match their type. But you can't replenish more flasks than your maximum amount allows. Makes sense. Seems like this game gives you all sorts of ways to replenish your flasks without having to actually go to a Grace. Let's just go ahead and rest up. And then, looks like we got another one of these jack-o'-lantern heads. Quick work of you, buddy. Smithing Stone 1. And alright. So back this way. We might even check out that Erd Tree area today as well. Time permitting. Where's this guy? Ow.
There's no mistake.
And I think I may have just messed up.
I'm sorry.
Stay down. Stay down. There we go. Looks like you just murdered somebody.
A tarnished, are you? I'm known as D. I hunt down those who live in death and weed their death root. Heed my warning. The village here has been touched by death. And worse yet, it is home to a mariner. If you value your life, then go no further. The village here has been touched by death. Turn back.
Okay, well, this is a FromSoft game, so we are not going to heed your warning. We're going to go where you tell us not to go. And another grace. Put these. There's graces everywhere. All right. Okay. Summon Water Village. Hey, buddy, you're not creepy at all. Where'd you go? Stun. Stagger, whatever you want to call it. Oh. I haven't really been noticing if it's building up blood loss or not. Is this guy just teleport all the way around? Summons enemies. Where'd you go, buddy? Okay. I feel like this is probably not gonna be good damage room, guys. Even better. Stop. And that's that. And another death root. Cool. Skeletal militiaman ashes. Decent amount of little runes off of him. Smithing stone. Looks like some crafting materials. Area. Mushroom. Yeah, I do say I am liking this Uchi. What about over in this section? stop it with your death magic. Somebody guarding something out here. Guess there's not that much to this place. This is just more I haven't seen yet. Okay, there's another section of ruins right here. Saw that explode out of him. And do we have a key? We do. Let's see what we got down here. Turtles. Off your shell. Okay. You guys just don't really fight back at all. It's okay. Turtle neck meat. That was it. Chest. Don't trap me. Green turtle talisman. Raises stamina. Okay. Yes, please. I'm gonna keep that one. See what's up that way. Looks like we got another church. Church that's on fire. Uh-oh. Take that blood loss. Gotcha. Sacred scorpion charm. Raises holy attack, but lowers your damage negation. Sounds like it's something for like a glass cannon style faith build. What do we got here? Nomadic Warriors Cookbook 14. Missionaries Cookbook 3. Go ahead and rest here. Oh, lady's back.
Forgive me. I've been testing you to determine if the Elden Ring would truly have you, if you had the metal to endure this long and arduous path. It seems my worries were unfounded. Torrent had your measure from the very start, whereas I merely pretended. There is but one other thing I can do to offer you guidance. I can take you to the Round Table Hold, gathering place of tarnished champions, guided by grace. Very well. Let my hand rest upon you for but a moment.
I wonder if this is going to be like your Firelink Shrine, like your central hub. The Roundtable Hold is a place where the Tarnished gather, guided by grace. Combat is prohibited here due to the Pact of Non-Aggression. This rule is in effect when the Roundtable Hold icon is displayed. This is located outside of the world. It can only be reached through the Sites of Grace. Can also be accessed by using the map to travel. Okay. Okay, yeah, so it's completely off the map. Looks like we have quite a few NPCs here. Well, I think that will wrap up this video. When we come back, we will explore all the dialogue of all the NPCs here, see what we got here, and then we might check out this area right here. I don't know if I want to push this way quite yet. It looks like a different zone, so we may explore this tiny little section of ridge and then start making our way up towards the Stormvale Castle. But anyways, hope you guys are enjoying this, and we'll see you in the next one.